Good afternoon, everybody. I first of all begin with an apology. Just before I 3 minutes of 12 when I clicked onto my computer to join you all today, it crashed. And so all the delay is mine, but it's a delay worth waiting for what we're about to hear. And I'm sure most of you know I'm Andy Levander, the chairman of the firm. And I want to welcome you to Deckard's Greater Middle Eastern Celebration during this Well-Being Week, diversity and inclusion, and reaching out to all of our communities is part of who we are at Deckard, and it's very exciting to have this performance and this meeting today. We strive as a firm to reflect the communities globally that we work in across the world, and we have taken tremendous strides and pride in doing that over the last decade. And this is just another manifestation of our broad outreach to our various communities, all of whom are important to us. Today we're going to use music as the medium. Music tends to, actually scientifically, according to Arif, and I always believe Arif, it actually has a stimulation of certain parts of the brain that make one feel better. This is going to be a very interesting performance that we're about to hear, and Arif will do the introductions on that. Today's event is also special because it is the first inaugural event of our newest affinity group, the Greater Middle Eastern Alliance, which is open and to anybody who associates or is affiliated with the broad swath of countries, languages and cultures that encompasses, and I welcome you all. The existing members already cover 23 different languages, ranging from Arabic to Farsi to Urdu, pretty interesting, pretty spectacular. So I would like to thank Arif personally, who is our co-head of international arbitration, for arranging this, for creating the affinity group, driving this forward, and for attracting a great first program that I'm interested to hear. This is, as I said, part of our greater diversity and inclusion platforms that we aspire to here at Deckard. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Arif to introduce our program and thank him again.
All right, Andy, well, thank you very much for that. Thank you for your attendance and welcome to everybody from around the Deckard community. And I should say marhaba and assalamu alaikum, which marhaba means welcome in Arabic and assalamu alaikum means peace to all of you, as this is the Greater Middle East affinity group. Perhaps we should also add a shalom. Almost 40 years ago, I recall sitting in the window seat of a Pan Am 747. Now, many of you may be too young to remember Pan American, but it was an iconic airline of the United States. When I was 18 years old, I was flying into New York City, and the pilot came over the PA and said, if you want to see why I do my job every day and love it, look out the right side of your window. And I looked out the right side of my window, and my breath was taken away by the sight of the Empire State Building for the very first time. And it's that soaring feeling that wasn't just the fact that I was somewhere thousands of feet up in the air, but the soaring feeling of the fact that I was coming to America, a country with incredible hope, multiculturalism, acceptance, and possibility. And of course, there have been times over the past years where that sense of aspiration has dimmed. And whenever it has, I turn to some of my favorite comfort strategies, including food, friendship, and music. And often that music is the music of Zeshan B, who you will be hearing from today. Zeshan is not just a friend, but indeed someone I consider a younger brother. He's an incredibly, incredibly talented musician, classically trained, a multi-instrumentalist. His debut album, Vetted, was released in April 2017. It was featured in the 10 New Artists You Need to Know by Rolling Stone in that same month. He's appeared on The Colbert Show, where he sang one of his signature tunes, Crying in the Streets. He and his wife, who is a frontline doctor, have appeared on MSNBC, and he recently released his new album, Melismatic. And I will say that during the summer, when we were all going through a very torrid and tough time on many levels, Zeshan's song, Brown Power, became an anthem across many sectors of society. And this week, as Annie mentioned, is about wellness. It's not just wellness for ourselves, it's about wellness for our community, wellness for each other, looking out for each other, making those connections. And on part of the Greater Middle East Alliance, the Affinity Group, this is our offering to our community to celebrate you, to celebrate our wellness, and hopefully see the cultural connections that that music can bring. And this particular event, Zeshan has titled, The Confluence of Influence, A Musical Odyssey in Four Acts. And with that, I'll turn it over to you, Zeshan.
Arifai, thank you for having me. Thank you for that, your wonderful words and for sharing your sentiments. Welcome to all of you. Arif, I call him Arif Bey. In our culture, it is considered respectful to call someone older and someone who is your brother, not just by their first name, but by attaching Bey to it. And it's my way of reminding Arif Bey that he's much, 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 much older than me. And and so I will refer to him as Arif Bey. And similarly, all of you who are tuned in, welcome, my brothers and sisters. It's great to be here. We're going to have a great time today. I'd like to really just start my talk with a song. You know, how about that? Because look, I figured I'm better at singing than talking anyway, right? So, as we start this odyssey, the confluence of influence, I'm going to sing this song, and I'd like you to, as I'm singing, I'd like to keep this as interactive as possible. Just a general note that if you have any questions, queries, concerns, compliments, complaints, whatever it is, please put them in the chat. I'd love to, not just talk at you for the next hour. I would really talk with you and engage with you. But I'm going to sing this song. Please just take a listen to it. And as you're listening, I've got two questions for you. One is if anyone can discern the language that I'm singing in, that might be a little bit easier. The second question is, does anyone know who the composer of this song is? And then, triple jeopardy is, does anyone know the name of the song? That if you have any inkling of that, please do put it in the chat. And so I'm going to go ahead and start the track. Oh, FYI, because of COVID, I couldn't get the band with me like they normally would be. So I'll be performing to a beautiful piano track by my collaborator, Aaron Kotler of Creekside Studios in Brooklyn. We're gonna get these tracks at you. Here we go with this one.
Ach, um deine feuchte Schwingen, West, wie sehr ich dich beneide, denn du kannst im Kunde bringen, was ich in der Träne.
Y'all, we're gonna go into three now. Oh,
eile denn zu meinen Liebe, spreche es ab zu seinem Herzen, doch vermeid ihn zu betrüben und verbieg ihm meine Schmerzen. Eile denn zu meinen Liebe, spreche es ab zu seinem Herzen, doch vermeid ihn zu betrüben, ihn verbieg ihm meine Schmerzen. Sag ihm aber, sag's bescheiden, seine Liebe sei mein Leben. Freudiges Gefühl von beiden, freudiges Gefühl von beiden, wird mir seine Nähe geben. Sag ihm aber, sag's bescheiden, seine Liebe sei mein Leben. Freudiges Gefühl von beiden, freudiges Gefühl von beiden, wir mit einer Nähe geben. Sag ihm aber bescheiden, seine Liebe sei mein Leben, sei mein Liebe, sei mein Liebe.
All right. So, I'm going to take, oh, look, somebody had an applause emoji. Thank you so much. Love the applause. Keep it coming. Keeps it going. Give some normalcy to this. That, folks, I'm just curious. So I'm going to look at the chat. Does anybody know what it was? Let's see. Sophia Abraham Mendoza says German. Great. Jeremy Zucker says Yiddish. Close enough. German, maybe Brahms. Okay, we're getting close. To kind of chime in, the song, this is correct. The song is in German. Let's see. Well, this is the most unexpected thing I've ever heard. I'm back in the shtetl. I love it. Let's see. Somebody. Okay. Well, it looks like people are very close to the song. Wow. Somebody actually knew the song. Whoa. That's crazy. You guys are way too classy. Marcus Bolsinger for the win on this one. Wow. I wasn't expecting that you guys would be able to, you know, discern not only the composer, but also the name of the song. But Marcus Bolsinger has won an all expenses paid trip to Germany, because he is correct. The answer is Schubert. Schubert wrote this song, and I'm just pulling up something real quick here. The song was written by Schubert. You are correct about that. And as far as the title, you know, Marcus got that right. But Mike can, or Jay, can we show them the title of this song? I'd really like for everybody to see the visual. Standing by for the title. You guys just got to see this, because it's gonna see, it's gonna be something you might not expect.
It is up now, Zeshan.
It's up. Okay. Let's see. Okay. As you can see, the title is Zuleika. Zuleika. Wow. That's not a very German sounding name, is it? And as we said, the composer is Schubert. We'll talk about Schubert in a second. And the lyricist was Goethe, Johann Wolfgang von Goethe, who is well known for having written Faust. And this is taken from his anthology, The Westöstliche Divan, as you can see in the screen. Can we just show them, fellas, AV, the Westöstliche Divan? I want everybody to see this. Woo, look at that. Talk about Orientalism. You got East on the left and West on the right. The Westöstliche Divan in German, and then on the left, all this beautiful Arabic calligraphy and the architecture and the aesthetics of that part of the world. Thank you guys for showing that. That's the Westöstliche Divan. And so back to the song, Schubert, you know, in the genre of classical music, first, you guys might be wondering, why is this very, non-German man singing this song? This guy who doesn't really look very German singing this song. Well, I'll tell you about it. So Schubert, you know, was a major composer in the early Romantic era. And we're talking about the early 1800s. And, you know, you guys are, this is a classy group of people. So a lot of people already know about Schubert. So, pardon me if I'm, you know, kind of telling you what you already know. But for those who don't know, Schubert was an extremely important composer. He wrote symphonies, chamber music, and, about 600 art songs like this. They're called Lieder. There's kind of its own genre. And it's what I had to study when I was, when I studied classical music at the conservatory. Songs, you know, compilations of songs like this, Die Schöne Müllerin, and other such wonderful tunes, great tunes. For those of you that are not maybe, familiar with Schubert, he also wrote Ave Maria. Ave Maria, gratia plena. He's also well known for that. I just want to talk about this because the lyrics of this song come from, they were attributed to Johann Goethe. You know, like I said, he is considered perhaps the greatest German literary figure of the modern era. This guy was a Renaissance man. He was a philosopher, poet, scientist, just all in one. And he has shaped Western thought and philosophy. He continues to shape it. And he's perhaps best known for having written Faust, the epic drama about, selling one soul to the devil, which is, also became an opera and is just a really, really big part of Western aesthetics. And this is a fellow, who we could, talking about influence, he's a real influencer. Everybody, there's influencer culture is a big thing now. Johann Goethe is a real, one of the original influencers. But guess what, folks? As we've seen from those visuals, Johann Goethe was hardly a paragon of Western hegemony, because this song was just one chapter in a huge anthology of his poems entitled Westöstlicher Divan, which you saw, which in its very title suggests quite an homage to Eastern culture. And why is that? Well, divan is a funny word. You know, it means different things to different people. In the West, it refers to a type of couch, like the Italians would say, siamo seduti al divano, we are seated at the couch. You know, in the East, it means anthology or a collection of poems. And by the way, usually those poems are about love and intoxication, often referred to as ghazals. We'll get into that in a little bit. But those poems, you know, because of the fact that they are often about the themes of love, intoxication, I would be willing to wager that the Urdu word diwana, which means to be crazy or crazy in love, comes from this root. So it has, you know, so many different triggers for people all across the world. But in the case of Goethe, he was absolutely fascinated with the divan, the anthology of another poet who preceded him by four centuries and who lived thousands of miles east of him. And this poet, this cat, like Goethe, was one of the most consequential writers of his corner of the earth. And I'm speaking of the Persian poet and philosopher Khwaja Shamsuddin Muhammad Hafezu Shirazi, a.k.a. Hafez. Yes, Hafez, folks. Zuleika is a song based on Hafez's literature. Zuleika is a character in one of his dramas. And by the way, I should point out that, and somebody had mentioned Brahms as being perhaps the composer. Close enough, Brahms was a, you know, was considered a contemporary in terms of music history to Schubert, because he was a, you know, Schubert was an early Romantic composer. Brahms would have been in the late Romantic era, but he's considered contemporary in that he also wrote Lieder just like this. And, you know, he was also fascinated with the East. And by the way, the songs of Goethe, I should point out, were composed by, were set to music, not just by Schubert, but by Schumann, by Wolf, by Brahms, I mentioned. And Brahms actually said about this song, Zuleika, he remarked that this song is the greatest song he ever heard, which is quite a tribute coming from Brahms. And, you know, so, you know, Hafez, so what, you know, why are we talking about this? Look, Hafez, he lived from 1316 to 1390 in what is now Iran. Goethe lived from 1749 to 1832 in what is now Germany. Now, why, you know, why is any of this important? Well, you know, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I just think it's pretty amazing that despite the enormous cultural gap and time gap, you know, between these two men, these two artists, these two philosophers, these two influencers, you know, Hafez had such a profound influence on Goethe. You know, he, you know, Goethe referred to Hafez as Heiligen Meister Hafez, High Master Hafez, you know, and Goethe wrote an entire anthology of poems that was then set to music by Schubert and the others that I spoke of. So, you know, I think it's interesting that these two, you know, I'd be willing to wager that when Hafez, breathed his last breath, that he wouldn't have imagined that 400 years later, this cat in Germany named Goethe would, you know, pick up his work and be like, man, I dig this. I want to set this, you know, and then that Schubert would then write a song. And then another 300 years later, a brown man like me would be talking to all of you about it. But, you know, perhaps more interesting, you know, is the fact that nothing in this song that I just sang, besides perhaps its title, Zuleika, you know, nothing about this song is overtly Persian sounding or Eastern or Oriental, you know, in its vibe, or what we think today would be Persian or Eastern, what we have constructed in our mind to be, you know, something that sounds like that, you know what I mean? Nothing about that song strikes, you know, when you hear it first, it's like, oh wow, that's clearly Persian. No, it's not. But does it have the indelible stamp of Hafez on there? You bet. And that's the point. That's the sauce right there that we're going to get into today, that our capacity as humans to influence each other in small ways is perhaps bigger and more profound than we even realize. And, you know, as a musician myself, you really get a front seat to this amazing show, this amazing odyssey of influence. So, we started our journey, folks, in Germany, in, you know, Berlin, and, you know, so now we're going to, you know, take a flight to North Africa, the Middle East, to Cairo, and we're going to also cover, you know, Tel Aviv, Istanbul, Athens. Everybody's going to be represented, you know, in this next chapter. So now we're at Act Two. I'd like to now sing something in Arabic, and I hope that I'm able to do justice. Supposedly, my great-grandfather was from Yemen, so apparently I have Arab blood in me, and so I guess we'll see if I'm able to do the language justice. Here's a song I'm curious if you might recognize, too. عندما تكسو القفار الدلاء تسكن البيد والربا والرمام وهواك ليس يغفو الجمال هما في الروح شعر وخيال آه يا أبا أين لي ذكر ليالي الطوال Well, folks, that is a lovely tune. I'm just going to, you know, I've been kind of jabbering here. I want to go into chat, make sure that we have an Arabic Dwan means a collection of poems. Wonderful. That song, it's a lovely tune. And, you know, it's called Mizerlu. You know, if you haven't heard it before, you know, before I just sang it, I guarantee that you will have heard it like this. Might have a technical issue right here. Might not be coming through all right. I think I'm having a little tech issue here, but basically what I was trying to if you hear you know the Dick Dale version of the which you may have heard you know everybody knows it as the Pulp Fiction tune you know so the Mizerlu is actually very familiar to those of us in the West, you know, because Dick Dale, the virtuoso guitarist who recorded that surf rock, you know, anthem, he is Lebanese. His real name is Richard Mansour. And, you know, he grew up listening to the music of his people. And this was, you know, such a popular guitar riff that others wanted to play it, you know, that others, so many people wanted to cover. There's the Beach Boys version of it. And, you know, look, once again, whoever wrote Mizerlu, and by the way, there's dispute as to whether it's the Turks, the Greeks, the Arabs, the Jews, you know, that I'll kind of let them continue to, you know, argue over that. That's not my place. But I will say, whoever did write Miserlou, I doubt that they ever imagined that someday, you know, a bunch of white surfer boys in California would be strumming the same riff, you know, that they that, and that would become just part of like the zeitgeist of surf rock. I wish I could play the track for you guys. I'm sorry that it's not working. But you know, I think you guys know very well what it sounds like. but it goes to show, you know, the syncretism, the universality, the sort of symbiosis inherently present in music. And so with that, you know, I want to hold this thought. You know, we're going to come back to Arabic music in just a bit. For now, I'd like to just take a slight detour and start talking about, you know, the sort of very disparate things that, you know, influenced me as a musician. We're going to take right now, basically, you know, we were in Cairo, you know, we're going to take a nonstop from Cairo to all the way to my hometown of Chicago. But when we get to Chicago, we're going to do a long distance call to India and Pakistan and Bangladesh, all those countries. We're going to do that from Chicago. I promise this will make a lot of sense. You know, so now we're in Chicago, and look, you know, we're at like ground zero for me. And, you know, when it comes to my own musical upbringing and my own sort of, Genesis, you know, I'll say I listen to it all. I listen to all types of music. I have to. It's part of what I do. Anything that sounds good, I listen to. But I will say that as far as my North Star is concerned, soul music and ghazal, those two genres, ghazal being from, it's originally a Persian form of poetry, but made very popular in India and Pakistan. Ghazal and soul are kind of home base for me. It's like, they're, like I said, my North Star. I bear sort of witness to the fact that, you know, there's a crystal clear nexus between soul music and ghazal. Because ultimately, those are two genres of music that are just about pain, anguish, poverty, and offers no solution to any of those problems. And having, you know, Indian immigrant parents myself, you know, along with grandparents who only spoke Urdu, there was no way that I could have avoided being, you know, influenced by the music that they listened to from back home. You know, there was the more lowbrow commercial music, like the film songs. And then, of course, there was the more highbrow, you know, very, you know, classy stuff like, you know, ghazal, geet, Hindustani classical, which we'll get to in a second. But then there was stuff in between, like Mehdi Hassan. And no, I'm not talking about the Al Jazeera journalist. He's a great guy. But I'm talking about the amazing sort of musical gem from South Asia, who I consider like a god. Mehdi Hassan was interesting because he was a classically trained singer who sang, you know, commercial music as well as the sort of highbrow stuff like ghazal, and boy, he was good at it. And he kind of carved his own sort of place in the world with that. He had some real hits in his time, but some of his lesser known tunes I think are just as interesting. And I'd like to, just for some context, take a stab at one of them, just to kind of get you guys in the zone for, you know, this journey across like soul and ghazal. Let's put this one. Ilahi aansu bhari zindagi kisi ko na de khushi ki baat hame bekasi kisi ko na de. that's a Mediasan classic, Ilahi Ansumbari. You know, to me, I'm curious what you guys think, but to me, there's something in the tune itself that's, you know, kind of on that sort of doo-wop tip. You know, it's kind of it's kind of, you know, ascending. And I'm seeing in the chat that Shabnam Afsa is saying we need the harmonium to go with this. Well, Shabnam Aunty, I got just a thing for you. I'm going to kind of wax on this this particular rag, and we're going to talk about rags too. But like, I have the visual here. I'm going to just kind of get a little comfortable. Pull up my good friend here, my harmonium, and we heard. So it's ascending. It's based on a rag, a scale that goes like this. That's kind of like the vibe. And so to me, that's very doo-wop because it's. And, you know, I would like to now turn your attention to another song that, you know, I just love drawing the nexuses between, you know, these things. You know, that you've heard the rag, like, that goes into Ilahi aansu bhari zindagi kisi ko na de. You know, somebody is asking, was that a type of accordion? It is, the harmonium is related to an accordion. It is a basically a pump organ. And to me, it's like kind of like my instrument of choice when I'm composing. And it's very popular it's very, you know, sort of idiomatic when it comes to the music of South Asia, the music of my ancestors. And so thank you for that wonderful question. Getting back to the rag that I was saying, the Ilahi aansu bhari zindagi kisi ko na de. You know, to me, there was something in this, there's a synchronicity between, you know, the lead singer in the original tune. I encourage you to listen to it. You know, things are climbing. There's like an ascendancy. And being from Chicago, you know, I grew up in that mecca of soul music that Chicago is. And now, of course, when it comes to, you know, Chicago soul, you know, we all sort of, you know of, you know, Curtis Mayfield, you know, the Impressions. People get ready, there's a train coming. Don't need no baggage, you just get on board. Or it's all right, it's all right. Have a good time, cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. You know, these are well-known sort of gems from Chicago, the Impressions, Donny Hathaway, you know, Lou Rawls, Earth, Wind, and Fire. You know, these we think of Chicago soul, but there are some artists who are virtually unknown, who I absolutely love, 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 love. And one of them is this cat named Cicero Blake. And I'd like to just kind of, in the same key, give you a little preview of one of his songs that I think is so beautiful. This one's called Sad Feeling, and this is a very, very idiomatic Chicago soul song. Here we go.
What it is to be lonely, to love someone who doesn't love you only. The pain inside makes you want to fall down and cry. Sad. sad feeling. Yes, it is. My, 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 my. You don't know what it feels to say I love you to someone else who's got nothing for you. The pain inside makes you want to fall down and cry, et cetera, et cetera. And you know, there, this is just kind of like an example of that doo-wop thing. It's, you know, it's ascending, it's going up and doom, 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 you know, and I think it's so interesting that as I was finding out that this song, Sad Feeling, I just sang, was written and recorded, you know, the very same year as the Mehdi Hassan song in 1964. Well, that's just crazy to me. The universe was really just kind of up to something, you know, and I kind of just sort of speaks to, like, you know, the stuff that's in the air that somehow travels that we don't even realize. I'm sure Cicero, Blake, Mehdi Hassan didn't know each other, but it's so cool that those two songs were composed in the same year. And, you know, so I think it's only natural that one of my own songs was influenced by both of these. And that, once again, that upward motion, doo-doo-doo. So I'm going to sing Stay. This song is called Stay. This is the first song on my album, Melismatic. And I really hope you guys like this one. Here we go. This was a Shangri-La, a city in the Garden of Eve. We never had to go far with all the thousand miles to feed. Oh yeah, I know it ain't much, but it's enough for us. I got the mightiest touch, and now it's getting hard to breathe. No more wood on the streets, I know, cause I ain't hearing the beat. So I'm down on my knees, I wanna stay. Hey, won't run away. No, I wanna play. Hey, just like we used to do. Back in the day, hey, full of teenage hopes, just let me stay, hey, like I used to do. We're going with the full song on this one. Yeah. It wasn't heaven on earth, but it kept us out of the cold. And if it keeps getting worse, then I won't recognize my own. No more wind on the streets, I know, cause I hear it beat. So I'm down on my knees, I wanna stay. Hey, won't run away. No, I wanna play. Hey, just like we used to do. If I can't go home. I wanna stay, won't run.
to do. Thank you, folks. That was Stay. And, you know, I would really love if you, you know, go online, go to iTunes, Spotify, check it out. I'd love for you to hear it with the full arrangement with strings and with full band. And, you know, I got more songs I'm going to be singing for you, and we're going to hear the full song. I hope you guys are enjoying, and I hope this is, you know, that you're learning something from this, and that this is making you feel good and, you know, a part of, you know, the wellness week. It's just, I think it's so great that you would include music in this. So we got more songs coming up for you. You know, I'd like to now, you know, we were, you know, we're going to head now in earnest to South Asia. We were in Chicago, but, you know, our layover is, you know, we're now going to take a little layover. We're going to fly over to, from Chicago to Lahore or Mumbai or Dhaka, whichever, you know, you fancy, but we're going to take a little layover in Dubai, you know, so that you know, we'll be in the Middle East for like a hot minute. And, you know, because I need to get back to Arabic music. You know, we need to get a little bit technical here, a little musical nerdy. I promise it won't be anything too crazy, but I, you know, I just wanted to kind of talk about the synchronicity of scales, you know, and, you know, are we all sort of familiar with scales in music, you know, seven notes going up and down, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, do, you know, well, it turns out that, you know, scales are pretty universal too. So let's get a little transcontinental. I just showed you a Western scale, which we use a lot here in America and in Europe. But let's go to the, you know, since we're in the Middle East, since we're in Dubai right now, since we're, you know, for our layover, in the Middle East, they use maqams. And it's, you know, for, you know, basically their scalar systems. Now, you know, there's a lot of scholarly debate in the music community about the definition of scales and whether scales are the same as maqams, ragas, etc. You know, I'll let people sort of duke that out. But on a basic level, you know, for the purposes of, you know, us kind of learning about each other, you know, I would say that there's way too much overlap between maqams and scales. And that, so I would just put them in the same category. There's a particular maqam in Arabic music that we're going to focus on today that has kind of been really central to my own musical odyssey. And that is, you know, maqam rast. It's a sort of scale, you know, basic, you know, scalar motion I'm going to show you real quick. Use my harmonium here. I'm going to go up to C. So it will basically, the scale, this maqam goes like, that's maqam rast. If you just sort of break it down, you know, and the reason this maqam is so had such an, you know, indelible impact on me is because I came from a Muslim family. And when I was a kid, you know, I had heard the sound, you know, of the azan, and I was able to, you know, it had such an impact because I was able to kind of imitate that same sound. And the azan, for those of you who don't know, and I, you guys are such a classy group, I'm sure all of you know what an azan is, but it's the call to prayer that, you know, you're going to hear if you go to any Muslim country at five times the day. You're going to hear like a sort of a kaleidoscope of azans going off from all different corners. Or if you watch any, you know, TV show about Homeland Security, you'll hear an azan there too. But less about that. You know, when I was a kid, I was the muezzin in my mosque due to my musical proclivities. And, you know, in the azan that I, you know, that I initially heard and that I would, you know, do in my mosque, you know, it's very much based in maqam rast. And for, you know, this is like for my Jewish brothers and sisters, I was basically a cantor,
and by Christianic brothers and sisters, I was basically an altar boy who sang, you know. So the azan is, you know, like I said, very commonly performed in Maqam Rust. And here's, you know, the kind of what I would have, you know, done as a, or what you would hear is like, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You know, very idiomatic kind of aspect of Maqam Rust that you're going to hear in that, that kind of standard azan. You know, and, you know, being a creative person at heart, I later came up with my own version of the azan. But, you know, when I started doing it as a kid, I would do it in Maqam Rust. And so, you know, we're going to now take that red eye flight to Lahore, Mumbai, or Dhaka, whichever you prefer. And, you know, talking about Maqam Rust, what I think is so cool is that the music of my mom and dad and my grandparents, the music that they listened to from India and Pakistan was also based on scalar concepts like maqams. And, you know, in this case, they're called ragas. And, you know, so, you know, these ragas are, you know, enormously important to any music that comes from South Asia, in commercial, classical, folk, whatever, ragas are embedded. And, you know, having grown up around that music, it, of course, they would have influenced me. And once again, the confluence of influence. There's hundreds of ragas out there, but there's one particular raga that I've used in my music, perhaps, and where I'm going to sing some of the songs around them, perhaps more than others, and it's called Rag Kafi. And it goes like this. This is a tanpura. This is what I use when I practice. That would be Rag Kafi. And, you know, I've written songs in Rag Kafi. I'd actually like to sing one. Because, like I said, I'm better at singing than talking anyway. This one is called Nosheen, and it sounds like this. For the same degree, you work so quietly, your eyes on the prize, not on a guy like me. I was tangled up in my own strings, learning how to spread my wings, finding my way to my right of spring. You have played with pain, had no time for games. Can't stop saying your name. No sheen. Forever you flow through my dreams. A slow motion movie scene. Fields of green. No sheen. As blinding as sun of the sea. Oh no, she. This one's for you, Jeremy. I push until I reach the sky, but the air gets cold up high. Breathing it in, I shiver and I sigh. The days turn into a blue malaise. I think about 100 ways I could have roamed the roads I've left unpaved. Oh, 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 oh. I don't know. Oh, oh, oh.
Why your grass is so green? No sheen. Forever you float to my dreams. A slow motion movie scene. Fields of green. No sheen. As easy as breathing to me. As blinding as sun off the sea. Oh no sheen. Thank you, y'all. That was Nosheen. And to kind of put this in context, you know, that is sort of my, you know, taking Raag Kafi and, like, you know, once again, I'd like to sing like one of the songs that, you know, that I would have heard growing up, Pyar Bhare Do Sharmile Ne. It's an Urdu song. It's beautiful, very romantic. Raag Kafi is centered around, and that's what's cool about these raags is that they, and that's why people say that they're not exactly like scales, because they have emotions and places and vibes associated with them. And Raag Kafi is associated with nighttime. So it's sacrilegious that I'm performing it now and it's not night. Oh my God. but it's also associated with romance. And so there's a beautiful song called Pyar Bhare Do Sharmile Nain, that's also in Raag Kafi, that I want to get in your guys' ear as we get to the finish line with this. And this is Pyar Bhare. Pyar Bhare Do Sharmile Jin Se Mila Mere Dil Ko Chain Koi Jaane Na Kyun Mujhse Sharmaye Kaise Mujhe तड़पाए प्यार भरे दो शर्मीले नैन. You're going to hear Raag Kafi on this course.
डर है मुझे तुझसे बिछड़ जाऊं खो के तुझे
मिलने की राह न पाऊं ऐसा न हो जब भी तेरा नाम लबों पर लाऊं मैं आंसू बन जाऊं जिनसे मिला मेरे दिल को चैन कोई जाने ना क्यों मुझसे शर्माए कैसे मुझे तड़पाए
So you can hear that. So at the end, I wanted to just kind of illustrate the overlap between that, you know, makam rust and raag kafi that you hear. And of course, those things would have been swirling around. Those would have influenced me. And, you know, those would have been part of my influences. Thank you, Arif Bhai, for sending the translations. It's really beautiful poetry. It's and especially at that time, they had lyricists who would, you know, who worked separately from the musicians themselves, who just wrote beautiful poetry. And I really strive to incorporate that in my own music. And speaking of which, I'd like to now sing one of my own songs that is also based on raag kafi. You've heard kind of what raag kafi sounds, the scale. Once again, sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Now you've heard kind of what it sounds in like a very, very idiomatic, you know, sort of what you would expect Indian, Pakistani, you know, Bangladeshi sort of context. That's kind of what you'd expect. I'd like you to hear it now in a context that perhaps you wouldn't, unless now that I've told you, you'll know, but like maybe you wouldn't have, you know, if I didn't tell you. This is my song. This is the favorite song off my album, Only in My Dreams. And I'm going to keep explaining this stuff. And guys, I have plenty of more songs and, you know, I'll perform more of them, you know, when we get to the end. This is Only in My Dreams. Maybe you can hear a little bit of raag kafi in this, maybe. Yes, no? Put in the comments. Let me know what you think.
Don't wake me up. Cause you know that I had enough. I'll go back to sleep. Cause this world isn't what it seems. The streets are paved with gold. Nobody's left out in the cold. We can live like kings and queens. Only in my dreams. The rich getting richer, you know. I'm here down deep in the hole. I do what I can, I'm only a man, I don't want to sell my soul. Maybe I'm delusional, to think that we could have it all. A piece of the pie never was untouchable. Oh, don't wake me up, cause you know that I had enough. I go back to sleep. Cause this world isn't what it seems. The streets are paved with gold. Nobody's left out in the cold. We can live like kings and queens. Oh, only in my dreams. Only in my dreams. Only in my cause this world isn't what it seems. Oh yeah, back in 85, phones were keeping hope alive. Driving for the man. Oh, if you're keeping hope alive. Driving for the man, you still had a chance, but now you gotta fight to survive. Maybe I'm delusional to think that we could have it all. Piece of the pie never was untouchable. Oh, don't wake me up,
cause you know that I had enough. I'll go back to sleep, cause this world isn't what it seems. The streets are perfect cold, nobody's left out in the cold. We can live like kings and queens, oh, only in my dreams.
Thank you, folks. I'm hoping that you are hearing the flourishes of Rag Kafi, and you know, hearing that within the context of the song that is kind of more indie pop and not necessarily something maybe you would expect is influenced by Indian stuff or Arabic music, or for, you know. But that's just sort of the beauty of it all, is that it's all, you know, each of us is, you know, kind of that gatekeeper of our own sphere of influence. And we're going to get into that more. So I wanted to just kind of, you know, and because I'd like to have some Q&A, and of course, you know, I'm willing to perform more songs if we have time. But, you know, I wanted to kind of share something special with you, you know, that no one else in the world has seen. This song, Only in My Dreams, you know, I recorded it, put it out last year. But just, you know, last week we finished filming a music video for it. And, you know, I would like to share this with you because, you know, here's where, you know, the influences start to really go in all kinds of crazy directions when you add visuals. It just sort of ratchets everything up to a whole different level. And, you know, I'd love to, you know, give you all a special advanced screening of it. Once again, this has not been put out in the world. This is a director's cut right here, folks. Mike or Jake, can we roll the clip? This is Only in My Dreams. You get to hear now the full song with band, and you get to watch the video too.
Cause you know that I've had enough. I'll go back to sleep, cause this world isn't what it seems. The streets are paved with gold, nobody's left out in the cold. We can live like kings and queens, only in my dreams. Oh,
Thanks a lot, folks. That was the unreleased video, music video of Only in My Dreams. That is, you know, special screening just for, you know, you Deckard cats. I hope it resonated with you. And, you know, that's like I said, that has not been put out in the world. So I wanted to share that with you just because I've, you know, finished filming it, you know, last week. But, you know, look, it's pretty weird video, right? There's all kinds of stuff in there. It's kind of trippy. You know, I wanted to just end with this vid because I really wanted to give you something tangible that shows the sort of culmination of all these things. Yes, this video is weird. It had all kinds of elements in it. Some things were overt, you know, some things were subtle. I don't want to point those out because I'd rather you just sort of reach your own conclusions with it. But no matter what, whether you can hear it or not, that video of that song has some trace of Mehdi Hassan in it, of Maqam Rast, of Raag Kafi, of the Azan, of Schubert, of Hafiz, of Goethe, you know, of the Azan, you know, that I used to sing when I was a kid, Chicago soul music, you know, Cicero Blake. It has all of those influences. And in the final analysis, that is the confluence of influence. That is the essence of music. And in many ways, just the essence of the human experiment, right? You know, we are all basically one confluence. We all collectively are just one confluence of our many, 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 many different influences. Big influences, small influences, good influences, bad influences. Each of us is a gatekeeper to our own sphere of influence. So, you know, for, you know, your wellness week and beyond, let's come together. Let's share our good influences with one another. It'll make for a lovely confluence, and it will make for some lovely music. Thank you so much, and I'm happy to turn it over to the floor for questions and answers, and would love to hear from all.
Well, Zeshan, thank you very much for that. That was truly amazing, as always, and I think we, you know, hopefully we can get some questions in before people have to head off in the chat. And maybe while those questions are coming in, if I can take a point of personal privilege to ask you to maybe sing a couple of my favorite songs, which you may have teed up.
I'd be happy.
And we'll see if any other questions are, if questions pop up.
I'd be happy to. I'm going to pull back here. You know, Arif Bey, one of his favorite, and I'm going to actually not even do it with the track. I'm going to just do it live, just like this.
As long as you don't sing the song that you wrote for me.
Arif Bey, Arif Bey. DC ka parishta, Arif Bey. Too many inside jokes here, folks. It's too much history. But one of Arif Bey's favorite songs, I think this is his favorite. First of all, are you guys hearing me okay? I switched to a different console here just so that I could get, I think it's coming through fine.
Not clear, Zay.
Thank you, Mike. One of Arif's favorite songs, Arif Bey's favorite songs is Crying in the Streets. I had the, you know, privilege of performing this on Late Show with Stephen Colbert in 2017. And I returned just last year to do another song that Arif Bey. This is Crying in the Streets.
Somebody
somebody crying, crying in the street.
Zeshan, yes, stunning, stunning, and thank you. I think we are probably getting close to, well, we're at the end. We have just a couple of quick questions, Zeshan. Perhaps I'll connect you with my colleague, Christian Nimak, who would like to get some raga recommendations. I don't know if you know the song Ahwak by Abdul Halim Hafiz.
I'm not familiar with that one, but that's what's cool about this exchange is that.
Okay, well, we're going to have to get you onto that song. In any event, Zeshan, thank you very much again. I'm sure you've made many other friends and fans. Others will be going to Spotify and iTunes and Apple Music and everywhere else. And we have one very, very important request that comes universally from all of us. Two. One is that we have a live performance with you at Deckard as soon as this pandemic is over. And the second is a warmest wishes to you and a great thanks to Alex. I hope she stays safe. We'll find another opportunity to do this again. So again, thank you. Zeshan, you get a virtual applause and cheers and standing ovation from all of us.
Thank you to all of you, and thank you to, I'm going to have to listen to that song, Ahwak. This is a beautiful outcome of this, is the confluence of our influences, sharing our wonderful influences with one another. So I'm going to check that out, and it's great to connect with all of you. I will be there when this pandemic ends, and we'll have a great time in person. Maybe I'll bring the band, we'll we'll get down. But thank you all, and it's such a blessing.